Okay. Look up, pencil. Did you take it with you? Why would I take my pencil to the bathroom with me?
I don't know. You're free to leave.
You're free to leave. Why are you getting all defensive about a pencil?
I'll help you look at it, okay?
A common issue for students who play sports is the misbelief that there's an inequality of funding.
I think it's unfair because some sports that are doing really well aren't getting as much money as sports who are not doing as well, who are getting more. Obviously, for the popular sports, there's more of like a demand, so you put more money into that sport in hopes of it getting better, but it really doesn't. We don't do fundraisers because, like I said, volleyball gets a lot of money. So, we don't really fund. Most of our money is booster money from our own moms, and they go to like concessions at football games, and that's where most of our money comes from.
One of the main causes for the inequality problem is the difference between a club and a real sport.
The more popular sports get funding because they're more of a priority than equestrian team is. I think that if we got some funding from the school that we could have better equipment and we could be more successful at competitions.
Despite many personal beliefs, there's no real inequality of funding between sports.
Typically the shoes. So, for example, football would be cleats, track would be track spikes. Those they need to supply, like if you're a swimmer, they have to provide their own swimsuit, because obviously you don't want to use the same suit year after year, you know, kind of gross. So those would be two. Those are really the only ones. Lacrosse, a lot of the lacrosse kids have to provide their own stuff. We do have a few helmets, a few sticks, but because that was a club sport before, it was just getting going, so there was not a lot of equipment. So typically lacrosse kids have their own equipment also. So each player has to pay insurance, which is $38. That's the only fee for all sports at West Ottawa.
Hey, Will, I'm Bree.
And I'm Claire.
It'll be a great day.
All you have to do is watch.
And WOBN starts now. Time zone, jump on it, jump on it, jump on it. You must have it, jump on it, jump on it, jump on it. Today, November 12th at 3, there will be a meeting in Coach Hart's room, A150, for all girls interested in track and field. This meeting will cover the conditioning opportunities for this upcoming season. If you can't attend, please contact Coach Holt or Coach Hart for more info.
There have been many complaints about how different sports are treated. Students are claiming that some sports get more attention than others. Bree and I have made a video for you guys to address the issue.
A common issue for students who play sports is the misbelief that there's an inequality of funding.
I think it's unfair because some sports that are doing really well aren't getting as much money as sports who are not doing as well, who are getting more. Obviously, for the popular sports, there's more of like a demand, so you put more money into that sport in hopes of it getting better, but it really doesn't. We don't do fundraisers because, like I said, volleyball gets a lot of money. So, we don't really fund. Most of our money is booster money from our own moms, and they go to like concessions at football games, and that's where most of our money comes from.
One of the main causes for the inequality problem is the difference between a club and a real sport.
The more popular sports get funding because they're more of a priority than equestrian team is. I think that if we got some funding from the school that we could have better equipment and we could be more successful at competitions.
Despite many personal beliefs, there's no real inequality of funding between sports.
Typically the shoes. So, for example, football would be cleats, track would be track spikes. Those they need to supply, like if you're a swimmer, they have to provide their own swimming swimsuit, because obviously you don't want to use the same suit year after year, you know, kind of gross. So those would be two. Those are really the only ones. Lacrosse, a lot of the lacrosse kids have to provide their own stuff. We do have a few helmets, a few sticks, but because that was a club sport before, it was just getting going, so there was not a lot of equipment. So typically lacrosse kids have their own equipment also.
Applications for the MHSAA Scholar Athlete are available in the athletic office. If you want to apply, you must have the applications in by November 24th.
Listen up, Wo. New sports are starting up for the winter season.
Varsity boys basketball will start at 6:30 to 8:30 and JV and freshman basketball at 5:30 to 8. All on November 17th in the North High School main gym.
Boys swimming and diving will begin at 4:30 to 8:30 on November 24th in the high school south pool. Wrestling will begin at 3:20 to 6:20 on November 17th in the North High School wrestling room.
But you can only get involved if you have a physical updated on file. If you are one of the people who have not done so already, you can get a form in the athletic office. Senior Survivor is on its way for the first time. 12 seniors will be locked in the school starting on Sunday, December 14, all for the charity. Whoever raises the most money or wins immunity stays in the game the longest. Stay tuned in so that you can be involved as well.
The Lip Dub is quickly approaching Woe. This year, the Lip Dub will be held in the North Building only, so all you Southies head over to North to be part of the Lip Dub. The Lip Dub will be held on Thursday, December 11. This year, the songs in the Lip Dub are Classic by MKTO, I'm a Believer by Smash Mouth, You're the One That I Want from the musical Grease, and On Top of the World by Imagine Dragons.
This year, there is a new club coming to Woe. This new club is Woe Pong, and it will be held in the LGI room once a week. Jessica took a closer look. Let's see what she's got.
Created by students Drew Berndt and Terry Yam under the supervision of Ms. Horvorts.
We wanted to have a cool thing to do in the winter season when most of us didn't have sports and we just had lifting. And we all love ping pong. We're really excited to start this club, and anyone who's really excited about ping pong should come on. You can come to our first meeting, which will be in the LGI room sometime after football. It'll be announced on WOBN. We'll meet in the LGI room after school. We'll start in the right after football season ends, and we'll continue possibly the spring. Anyone who's serious about ping pong and would like something to do sometimes after school in the winter.
The club will be meeting right here in the LGI room, and looking around, they could probably use some ping pong tables.
We have about 3 or 4 tables, and in order for us to have more members in the club, we need to have more tables.
Contact either of the co-founders, Drew Berndt or Terry Yam, for more information.
Mrs. Hausler is waiting for those acceptance letters, seniors. Make sure you bring them to the front office.
You can also follow at GoWo_college on Twitter for any updates or alerts.
Also, there is a new page up on the school webpage.
If you are looking for a job, you can go to the parent resources, giving you the opportunity to connect with the employee.
Seniors' pictures are now due on November 21st. You can get a form at both the North and South building reception desks. Make sure you get them in on time.
Dual enrollment deadlines are quickly approaching. If you are interested in taking a dual enrollment class, please go to dual enrollment page under counseling from the West Ottawa website to download the paperwork. Fill it out and get it to Mr. Veldkamp in the South Counseling Office ASAP.
There will be a Well Renaissance meeting in the North Building, room 133.
All are welcome to join.
The meeting will be next Monday, November 24 at 3.
Well, West Ottawa, that's all we got.
Make it a great day and the rest of the week.
Until next time, I'm Claire.
And I'm Bree, signing off for WOBN.
If I was Jay-Z, you'd be my Beyonce. We could rock the nation like they do. And if I was Da Vinci, you'd be Mona Lisa. Paint a smile perfectly on you.